Daniela, and we are going to present the prepositional phrases functioning as an adjective or as an adverb.
A prepositional phrase is a group of words containing prepositions. It lacks either a verb or a subject, and that function as a unified part of speech. It normally consists of a preposition and a noun, or a preposition and a pronoun. It can function as an adjective, modifying the noun, or as an adverb, modifying verbs or another adverb. To start, we have our phrase, our sentence. It says, the store at the corner sells pens, but there is a promotion that if you climb up the hill, you will get one for free. This is a compound complex sentence, and we are going to start diagramming.
Okay. Then we start the diagram with the subject, that is the store. And we have to choose the main clause. This is a common noun, functioning as a subject. This is the subject. Then we have to write sells. That is the verb in present, simple present. And then tense. This one is the direct object. Why is it direct object? Because it says, what are they selling? They are selling tense. And this is a common noun. Then we have the, this one, the, that is a definite article. Then we have at the corner, this one is the prepositional phrase. It goes under store because it is affecting, describing the store. At, this is the preposition, and the corner is a common noun, that is also the object of the preposition. And then we have to break this, the, under corner. All of these prepositional phrase is functioning as an adjective because it is describing store. Where is the store? At the corner.
Okay, then we have the other sentence that says, but there is a promotion. And it starts with the coordinating conjunction, but. So we're going to put a dotted line here. And we put but. That is a coordinating conjunction. And then we start with there. That is an expletive. So we put it here. It's an expletive. An expletive is a word that you can put or delete, and the phrase or the sentence is still coherent. Okay, and then we start with our subject, that is promotion. That is a common noun, functioning as a subject. And then we have the indefinite article a. Then we have our verb. The verb is the verb to be, is. And it's in simple present. It is a linking verb in simple present, and it's the verb to be. have to put our diagram like this. Then we have the other sentence that says that if you climb up the hill. This sentence is embedded in this main sentence, so we have to put the tripod. And first we have you, that is our subject, and it's a personal pronoun. Then we have will get. This is a phrasal verb. As you can see, you have two verbs. This will is functioning as an auxiliary. And get is our main verb. And all this is a phrasal. And then we have our noun, that is one. It is a common noun. And then we have another preposition or phrase that is for, which is our preposition. And then we have free, which is our common noun. Functioning as the object of the preposition. This prepositional phrase is working as an adjective. Because it is modifying the noun.
And then the last part, that is, if you climb up the hill, we have to write a dotted line right here from will get. If this one is a subordinating conjunction. And then we have to write the diagram using you, that is a personal pronoun. Personal pronoun functioning as a subject. And then climb. That is the verb. Under the verb, we have to write the prepositional phrase that is up the hill. Up the hill has to be under climb. We have to write up, that is a preposition. This one is a verb in present. In present. Then we have to write hill, that is the common noun. And it's the object of the preposition. Object of the preposition. And that is a definite article. All of these, all the prepositional phrase is functioning as an adverb. Why? Because it is affecting climb. It is affecting, it is describing where you have to climb. Where? Up the hill. All of these is functioning as a noun clause. Functioning as a predicate.
So, just to wrap up, a prepositional phrase can work as an adjective, as you can see here. Because it is modifying the noun. Or it can also work as an adverb, as here, when it is modifying a verb or another adverb. In this case, it's just modifying a verb. And that's it.
Thank you for your attention. We hope you enjoyed it and that you understand all of these diagrams. And
have a nice day.